we're gonna need to figure out.
Hey everyone, it's great to see you again. Michael here, and this week I'm talking to you about Whovia. Now, Whovia is actually from my hometown of San Diego, California. It was founded in 2013 by, I'm not going to pronounce this right, Dr. YY Zhao. Now, they are in the event app space, very competitive with us. A little bit, again, of a smaller company, about 50, 60 employees, it looks like. So, with that being said, let's go ahead and take a look under the hood.
Now, this right here, this view that we currently have, this is the administrator view of their backend on my iPad. I'm not able to access any kind of build tools, so I don't know how much more comprehensive they are. They do have this admin toolkit, though, that lets you do some just really basic reporting, send out announce and reminders, send out polls, things like that. You can also get some stats and function as a moderator, tips. There's a few other features here. Not a whole lot of options, but it is displayed very nicely. Now, the biggest difference is if we go to view this as an attendee, we don't see any of those administrative tools. So all we see is this exhibitor hub, which is a really nice feature, actually. It lets the exhibitors kind of control a lot of things. Now, there's a lot of really fun features here. Going through this, the layout doesn't seem to be really changeable, and I compared this with a lot of other demos and videos and things. So this layout seems pretty standard. I'm not sure how much you can do, but the additional resources, they do have a lot of options. From what I saw in the pricing, all these options do seem to be included. We can see this if we go take a look, I think, at the leaderboard. So they already have a lot of these built out. The leaderboard looks nice. It displays really well. And you can go in and see your points. Now, how you find the games here, they have the challenges set up, how many points you can get. Standard gamification, and then they have a prize store that's available. Now, there are some interesting pop-ups that come up with this. I've clicked on most of these at this point, so we're not seeing a lot of them, but let's see. Let's try passports. I don't think I've done that one, so that might have some pop-ups we're looking for. No. They do have stamp collection, so the passport kind of functions in a cool way that links with exhibitors. Maybe surveys. Oh, there's some of those pop-ups I was talking about. Now, I am on Wi-Fi, and one thing I will say just in playing with this demo is everything does take a little bit of time to load. It's not quite as responsive as a lot of the apps and other products that I've seen. But where I think it's a little bit more interesting is if we take a look at how the agenda is laid out in here. Now, if we go to any one of these sessions that you see have these live little green cameras over to the left, like this one. Then we come up with all the different options. Now, I don't know, again, if it's because maybe something's not going on right now. The session's not scheduled till the 22nd, but let's go ahead and click this live stream button. Gonna go ahead and proceed anyway. Now, I'm not sure how this would work with more people, but it does have a video conferencing tool somewhat embedded in it. Now, what the limitations are, how many people they can have, it's pretty up in the air. And I frankly am very frustrated with the display. As you can see, it cuts me off. I have to hold it really at arm's length to even be able to fit on the screen. So it's a lot of really, really intense eye shots. It does also have some interesting features, though, if we take a look. So we have the ability to switch cameras on our device, start and stop video, audio, see the participants, share content from a device. And then if we go to more, they have some interactive options, clapping, thumbs up, you can chat, look at meeting settings, and raise your hand. So it has a little bit more of an expansive suite of controls than I think we've seen in a lot of virtual meeting apps for the users. Then this watch on the desktop is where I really struggled, because I wanted to try this on the desktop and to show you what that looks like. But if we click watch on desktop, it says something gets emailed to me. I've done this about a half dozen times, and as of yet, nothing has been emailed. Or I should say, I've gotten a lot of emails from them, but nothing that lets me view anything on my desktop. And then let's look at the community. So this would be the feeds, and at least in this example, they have a ton set up. So they have organizer announcements, which is a fairly good idea, but that's separated from a lot. So I would never have this many different feeds. But as an example or as a demo, it's pretty interesting. And you have the ability to follow them. So you're not kind of forced to go into them, but you can create a variety and then choose which ones you want to see. And then you can sort by the ones you are following and whether there's any new topics in any of the feeds at all. So that's a spin around the app, both the back end and the front end, and a little bit of what their virtual offerings are. Again, I'm not sure what the limitations are, but let's take a look and see what we can find out real quick. Now, as far as Whova's virtual offerings, let's get a little bit more information on that, because I do think it's interesting. So here's what they have to say about themselves thus far.
Helped hundreds of organizers move their events online. Whova integrates with Zoom, WebEx, Microsoft Teams, Google Meet, GoToMeeting, and other various live stream services. And it also allows you to conveniently add videos from Vimeo, YouTube, Dailymotion, Wistia, and others, as well as Whova's own video hosting. With the integration, you can easily create and manage your virtual session within one place, and conveniently remind and engage your attendees and speakers. They can actively participate in your event through live polls, live Q&A, and also through a discussion board, and they can also virtually network with each other even before the event starts.
So, now this seems pretty simple, I'm sure, but you're probably wondering, if you do have an issue, how do you get support? And that's a great question. In the app, it has a help button, but that just takes you to a page that has instructions on how to utilize the app. It doesn't seem like there's any live support within the app itself. Now, if we go to the website, they have an 800 number, email, some other ways that you can contact them. Really, those are it, though. So there's no chat feature on here that makes it easy to just reach out or get any live support. So I would be a little nervous as far as feeling confident if something does go wrong that I would be able to get help immediately, just with what I've been able to see. I do want to quickly mention a few other things that they do. So not only do they have the virtual offerings, which seem basically part of their mobile event app, but they also have online registration, which is something that we get asked about a lot, and then event marketing. And now, last but not least, let's talk about pricing. So on the one hand, the pricing that I was able to find is about their registration information. So the registration caps out at about $5 a ticket. That's the maximum fee. So even if they're charging $500 a ticket for an event, they never make more than $5, which seems like a really low rate for the registration software. Now, finding prices on the event management software is incredibly hard. I've spent some time combing through the internet, haven't been able to pull up anything, any secret information. Everything just takes me back to their pricing demo page, which I filled out their demo requests and things like that a few times and still haven't gotten responses. But on G2, they at least did provide a little comparison. Again, I'm not sure where they get these numbers from, but they do seem on the less expensive side, if any of this is true and valid. But again, without any pricing information online, we have no way to know at all. All right, that's it for me. Thanks for your time this week. And I think I'd better go.